Our second video of today's online class, we come to the 23rd question of the topic respiration. The 23rd question is a give reason question where we have different parts. The first part is saying that glottis is guarded by epiglottis. You need to understand again that this epiglottis is a cartilaginous flap-like structure present over the glottis, which is the entry point of the trachea. It is guarded by to avoid the entry of any food particle inside the trachea whenever food is swallowed inside. B part pe aajaiye, lung alveoli are covered with capillaries. Why the capillaries are present there? So that during the exchange of gases, the oxygen that can enter the blood capillaries, it will be directly taken to the different tissue and cells. And similarly, carbon dioxide through the blood capillaries can reach the surface of alveoli and it can be easily passed to the, directly come to the blood capillary and it can pass to the alveoli surface. Come to the next part, C part. Walls of trachea is supported by cartilaginous rings. It is again done so that in absence of air, the trachea will not collapse. Come to D part. Multicellulars require special organ for exchange of gases. It is because in multicellular, all the complete cells or the, all the cells are not in direct contact with the atmosphere. The way unicellular have their complete body surface covered by environment or atmosphere, it is not happening in multicellular. So diffusion alone cannot help in the exchange of gases, because if diffusion even have to cross from one cell to other, it will be a very, very slow process. Come to E part. Aquatic organism breathe faster than terrestrial organism. Again, the same answer, that the amount of dissolved oxygen in water is comparatively very less to what it is found in the form in the atmosphere. Come to F part. Diffusion is insufficient to meet oxygen requirement in multicellular. Same question we have discussed will be answered over here also. Come to 24th question now. The 24th question over here discusses that what happens to carbon dioxide which collects in the human tissue. Do you remember what happens to carbon dioxide? 23% of that carbon dioxide travels through hemoglobin by making the form of carbaminohemoglobin and reaches to the blood capillaries along the alveoli. And the other percentage, near more than 70%, travels in the form of sodium carbonate, and the rest 7% travels in the form of carbonic acid. So in a way we can say the carbon dioxide produced in the tissue, that collects in the tissue, travels in the blood in its dissolved form. It reaches the blood capillaries around the alveoli. From there, exchange of gas will happen. CO2 will cross the blood capillaries and enter into the alveoli. From the alveoli, it will take a reverse path to reach the bronchiole, then bronchi, then bronchus, then trachea, then pharynx, then the nasal passage, and from nostril, it will go outside the body. Now, 25th question. How are lungs designed in humans to maximize the area of exchange of gases? How are alveoli designed? So the first question says that how lungs are designed to maximize the area. It is done by using alveoli. If you remember the alveoli, they are large cloud-like structures. So in that form, they are increasing the surface area. 26th question. Why mammals require more extensive respiratory surface? It is because mammals are homeotherms. Homeotherms ka matlab, therm matlab temperature. Homeo means same. Mammals try to keep the same body temperature and doesn't get affected by the kind of temperature outside present in it. So, to maintain the same temperature, it has to continuously do certain reactions and produce that amount of body heat. That means its need of energy will be much greater than compared to the other phylums of the animal kingdom. And that is why mammals requires more extensive respiratory surface, so that more exchange of gases can happen and more oxidation of glucose can happen, producing large amount of heat. Second part of the question, Name the end parts of respiratory system. It is alveoli. 27th question. What will happen if diaphragm is ruptured? If diaphragm is ruptured, it will not be able to be flexible and move. In that case, it will not be able to increase or decrease the volume of the thoracic cavity where the lungs are placed. So inhalation and exhalation will be affected and respiration will also be affected for this. 28th question. Explain how gaseous exchange takes place in first amoeba, B part fish. For doing this question, draw the complete diagram of both of them. In amoeba, talk about diffusion, how diffusion causes the entry of oxygen from high to lower concentration inside the cell, and how carbon dioxide moves from its higher concentration in the amoeba to outside because of low concentration outside. So in B fish part, talk about that it's an aquatic organism. Name the parts responsible like mouth, gills, operculum. Explain the complete direction of water, how they take in the dissolved oxygen and give out the dissolved carbon dioxide. Talk about the faster rate in fish. The 4 to 5 points will be covered over here in this answer. 29th question. Explain how gaseous exchange during breathing cycle, even after forceful exhalation, gaseous exchange still take place. Again, the same answer. You have to talk about residual volume and explain the answer. B part. In green plants, during day, CO2 is generated but not released. It is because this CO2 in the daytime will be utilized in the photosynthesis process. So it will not be released. 30th question. What is the main function of Adam's apple? See, Adam's apple is nothing but the voice box, which is also known as the larynx. So it is used to produce the sound. Next question. State two components of photorespiration. This photorespiration happens in specialized desert plants. So here, different temporal separation is happening. That means in daytime and nighttime, the stomata closes and opens in different forms. So we will discussing it as Hort's question. Next, 31st question. Why do mammals require more extensive respiratory system? We have done this answer as respiratory surface. Same answer will be written over here. Next question. Difference between plant and animal respiration. We have done that. Right and left lung. We have done. Breathing and respiration. We have done. Respiration and photosynthesis. We have done. Inhalation and exhalation. I will be sending. Then internal and external respiration we have done. It is the same as cellular and breathing. Same difference is there. Aerobic, anaerobic and partial aerobic respiration we are going to again send it to you. Come to 33rd question. You went to your village where everybody is in panic due to death taking place of people sleeping under the large peepal tree at night. Explain the scientific reason. 33rd question is an innovative question. So if you know that in the night time, the photosynthesis is not happening. So only and only which process will undergo? Respiration will undergo. That means this huge peepal tree or banyan tree having so many number of leaves will have only one process. It will take in the oxygen and give out CO2. So a person who is sleeping just under that tree will exhale more amount of carbon dioxide and will not be able to inhale more amount of oxygen. So the inability of getting oxygen to all the cells of the body causes death of the person. Okay, so there is no supernatural activity connected to it. 34th question. In a newspaper article, you came to know about the death of the family inside their cemented room. Cemented room, that means no ventilation, no exchange of gas, where they were using burning coal. Burning coal means if the coal is burning in the limited presence or absence of oxygen, it will not be burned properly. First problem, soot particles will be formed. Second, in the place of carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide will be formed. Now, this carbon monoxide has higher affinity for hemoglobin as compared to oxygen. So, in the presence of more carbon monoxide in the room compared to the oxygen, the hemoglobin will start bonding with these carbon monoxide, forming what? It will form carboxyhemoglobin. So this causes the hemoglobin not to carry oxygen to the desired cells required in the body. So for example, the brain cells are not getting the required amount of oxygen, and because of that, ultimate death of the cells will start happening and this causes the death of the person. We have already discussed while discussing respiration. 35th question, from 35th question to 45 we are going to do in our next video.